Hi, everyone, and welcome to Sip and Sync with Azure. In this episode, we're talking about MCP, Model Context Protocol. And I've invited Krystal back on the show.
Thank you for having me and inviting me back.
Awesome. So Model Context Protocol, as we all know, is all about making our AI applications extensible, easy to talk to each other by providing it common ground to talk to each, talk to different applications together so that they are more efficient and we can, as programmers, as developers, we can build with them faster, just like APIs, right?
Correct.
So APIs used to do that for helping us build our website, connect with our backends and databases. I kind of think of MCP in a very similar way, but now in the age of AI agents, you're able to connect these agents that are doing very different things, and the agents are talking to our backends as well. So bringing all of that together and doing it seamlessly with a lens of a common way to talk to each other. So that's kind of the context I have about MCP. I'd love to learn from you what you think about MCP and define it a little bit for us.
Yeah. So what I think about it in MCP is really trying to understand how to have that context awareness, streamline different intersections of tools and processes that you can help as you develop your applications or within the IDE. So MCP is really allowing you to kind of gather multiple extensibility between those tools, which is really powerful because this helps me be productive and as well as help developers kind of stay in the flow again. So so I'm excited to kind of share a little bit about how that actually works within Visual Studio Code Insiders. And so
let's get into the excitement.
So first thing you need to do is have Visual Studio Code Insiders. Within Insiders, you have to check your settings so that you can enable MCP. So I'm going to go to my preferences and then go to settings where you're able to do that. Search for MCP. And so you'll see that it's enabled and enabled. So make sure that's enabled, and then you're able to jump into those settings. And so as I'm trying to do those settings, you could see here that it's empty, and I'm going to add that into Copilot Chat. So the first thing you'll have to go is into the chat here, and then actually make sure that you're in agent mode. So you have the three new things here, ask, edit, and agent. In agent mode, that's where you're able to use that extensibility and add in different MCP servers. With that, I'm gonna actually click on this tools where you can see select tools, and you'll be able to add that MCP server here. And so there's different ways to add that. You can download it from Docker, Python packages, Node packages, NPM, or you can just hit an endpoint directly. Or you can have it running locally within your machine and then have that server running. So with all that, you can basically have multiple ways that you can connect to that. I'm going to use an NPM installer, and I'm going to use that between an open sourced MCP protocol that I have found from a colleague here. And so so this is kind of where an open source, and I'm going to use that and be able to extend to Playwright. So I would like to kind of keep working with Playwright to be able to use that extensibility as I'm doing UI changes for my application. So I'm going to add this one in there.
Talk to us a little bit about Playwright before you dive into it. What does Playwright do?
Yeah, Playwright is basically a tool where you're able to do automation for UI performance testing and as well as just use case testing as well to see ability to do different types of tests on the platform to kind of simulate that as a user experience. So you can do authorization, login, you can do different things that says, hey, performance, different load time. So load testing and as well as that is pretty cool with Playwright. So it is an open source software that we also have on the platform where you can run container instances on Azure.
So we're taking this MCP server and going to interface that into our GitHub Copilot chat so that we can do all of this testing within our GitHub Copilot chat.
Yes, exactly.
Okay,
got so it. I want to be able to basically extend Playwright accessibility into my Copilot chat. So as I'm designing and doing stuff for my application, I'm able to do that directly through natural language in the chat. Perfect. So that's really what I'm, it's so powerful. So first thing we're going to do is actually see how we can configure and enable this within our Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to actually get this because this is using node packages. And so I'm going to actually try to add that server directly into Copilot chat. The first thing you need to see here is that you're in agent mode. With agent mode, you're able to add additional tools for now. And so that adds the extensibility directly into the chat. So as I add that tools here, I'll have an NPM package and I'm going to put the package name here and then I'm going to allow it, making sure that you know you use a trusted vendor because you want to make sure that as these tools come out, you want to be able to make sure that they're vetted when you're adding those into your environment. So I'm going to just call it Playwright and I'm going to add it back into my user settings for all my workspaces for now. And so you'll see here that it's already, I'm going to start it and get it running. And you can see that it's going to have the arguments here, and then it's going to show that the tools has updated, where it has 15 tools that I can add. And so you can just keep adding tools and tools into Copilot chat as you're using agent mode. And so with that, you have different ways that you can interact with this one. This one is Playwright, so it can say, hey, I can say, Copilot, I want to navigate to browse a particular URL. And so let me show you how that kind of works and show how it works within the chat. So with that, I'm going to just say hashtag, I have to say browser navigate. And so I'm going to navigate to just our default AI apps template. And so this is kind of our sample AI apps. And I'm within the chat, I can basically extend and be able to kind of do that. And so it's going to take me there and I can do other Playwright commands. So if I had any Playwright scripts and I wanted to say, integrate my Playwright scripts, use Copilot chat to help me do that in the agent mode, and then use the extensibility to kind of run those commands as I'm doing that in the code. So it's a really cool tool to just extend anything that really powerful that you have, you know, connections to for different products and services. So
yeah. So in this case, we ended up extending our GitHub Copilot chat with Playwright using the Playwright MCP server. But imagine the other possibilities, right? Like if you had a travel application which does itinerary for you. And let's say I said I'm going to Japan for a week and book me the entire thing. I like to do cultural stuff and it's going to be a week and there's going to be maybe two kids with right as well. So all that context that goes in, now you need to do a reservation agent, there might be a hotel reservation agent, there might be a flight reservation agent, and there might be an agent for activities that I'm going to do based on the interest that I mentioned, right? All of that is going to then talk to the APIs behind the scenes. Like there's the flights API, then there's the database for all the activities that are possible. And so think about all of those different APIs and extensions that we need to go to get the entire itinerary built up. And those could all be that they're all talking in the same language, the context, the model, that's the data model that's coming back. You're able to standardize all of that with MCP extensions. So this was just one example, but think of the possibilities in your use cases. And hopefully, with this, you're able to imagine what that could look like and be able to give it a try while you're developing in GitHub Copilot. Anything else you'd like to add in terms of benefits?
Yeah, I think the main three benefits is like being able to collaborate across different products and tools across your team, where you're able to add that extensibility specifically within the chat, and then also help reduce errors and streamline it. I think that's part of the thing is like being able to have that extensibility to other products, other sources and things that you have within an organization could be pretty broad. Yeah. So that extensibility and making sure that you can make it unique for each developer's needs. So instead of, hey, I need all these tools to be able to be productive and also make that my experience coding that much great.
So true. And I the one of the analogies that I can think of is when you apply extensions to your laptop, like it's kind of like that. Like you can connect different things to it. And that's kind of what MCP is helping you do. With that, thank you so much for joining us today and showing us this amazing demo, Krystal. And thank you all for joining us in this episode. And we look forward to seeing you in the next one. In the meantime, don't forget to like and subscribe if you're enjoying the series. Let us know in the comments below.